What's up, guys? Welcome back. If you've clicked on this video, it means you have decided that you want to get yourself a credit over the refund. An excellent, excellent choice. You want to know why you made the right choice? Let me tell you. But first, on this channel, my name is Shiraz, here on Thumbs Up Run, where we talk about buying tickets, selling tickets, and making sure that you have all the fun with your tickets. Best way to have fun with those tickets is by hitting that little subscribe button below and the little bell icon to make sure that you never miss out on other content ever again. With that being said, I want to tell you the five reasons why picking the credit over the refund is the way to go. Let's begin. Number one, you like free stuff. You like to be told that you are able to get some free things, extra value, extra stuff, extra anything, free, free, free. Everybody loves free stuff. It's amazing. And the credits, they're all about that free stuff. So they're going to give you credit, and not only that, they're going to give you a bonus credit. They're not going to give you 5%. Sometimes they'll give you 10%. Sometimes they'll give you 15%. Sometimes they'll even give you 50%. 50% free money. Yes, please. Now you can take all that free money, go ahead, apply it towards another purchase. One, it could be to upgrade to that same event in the future and get yourself a nice, better seat. Or you can take that credit and actually apply to two or more events and make sure you have twice the amount of fun than you would have had with just the one time. Free stuff? Can't go wrong. Number two, you've already committed to your entertainment budget. Yes, you've already bought the ticket in the past. You find out the event has been postponed. You don't know what's going on. You've been given a choice to take a refund or a credit. What are you going to do? You take the credit because one, you've already allocated the money towards that entertainment budget, and two, you don't want to go through the hassle. Once you've already allocated the funds and you got that cash back, then that money might get used for less entertaining things. Could go towards bills, could go towards groceries, could go towards, you know, other stuff. But we want our entertainment budget to go towards entertainment. So if we leave the money with the credit, we can go ahead and use that credit in the future, have a lot of fun, make sure we don't have to think about it ever again. Again, it's already been allocated, so why would we unallocate our fun money? No. Our fun money stays in the fun money budget. We don't move that out. And also, the money's already been spent, so it's like it's having free money that you just spent twice. You've already spent it once on the event, you find out it's been postponed, fine, blah, blah, blah. A couple months down the road, you find out you're gonna be able to use your credit and you can now buy another event. It's like buying something twice. It's like using the same money two times. It's twice the fun. You gotta take the credit. You gotta sing the baby. Number three, it's all about the scheduling. With scheduling, you might have had a problem with the potential event date that was going to take place in the future. Only now you find out the event has actually been postponed indefinitely. We have no idea when it's going to take place. It means that you now have the opportunity to go ahead, plan your day, your week, your month, your year around the newly scheduled date once it is announced. This is fantastic. You can go ahead and make sure you actually are committed to going to that event in the future. There are no more problems. You can go ahead and say, okay, I am committing to this date. Nothing will stop me now. Fantastic. Also, having the credit on hand means you don't need to, again, spend any of that money because you've already spent it. So that credit, it'll help you with that scheduling. You can go ahead and apply it directly and immediately towards that future purchase. This is what I think. I think it's definitely the right choice. So having the ability to schedule things in advance, fantastic. Definitely makes me want to take the credit. Number four, buyer's remorse. Might have heard this one before, but let's discuss, shall we? Buyer's remorse, you bought tickets to that event. You were really excited to go. I mean, you were really excited to go. Unfortunately, that event has now been postponed. It's no longer taking place. It's no longer happening. Nothing you can do about it. It's so sad. I really, really wanted to go to event. Insert event here. You wanted to go see the Sens take on, you know, the Buffalo Sabres. I mean, yeah, I'm sure you would have had a great time. Fantastic. Wonderful. But now that I have this credit, unfortunately, that Buffalo game is no longer working with me anymore. And now I have the ability to pick the event I want to go see so I can go watch them play, you know, someone more exciting. Yes. Having control is always the best. Being in charge of things, fantastic. Again, you are able to get out of things if you pick the credit. Means you have the ability to go ahead, pick the event you want to go to. If you take the cash, means everybody gets their money back. They can go ahead, spend on whatever they want. But now you can commit your friends to attending things with you that you want to see. And number five, you're not boring. If you are boring, you'll go ahead, you'll take the cash back. You'll have it in your pocket. You'll use it for this thing and that thing and all the other things. All the boring stuff. You've already allocated the fun money to the fun bucket. Therefore, why would you try and be unfun and boring by taking money out the fun bucket? You've already committed, just leave the money as a credit. It'll be awesome, it'll be great. You'll be able to spend it immediately once the new event dates have been set and you know what you're gonna spend it on. It's gonna be fantastic. Keep the credit there. It means it'll remind you that you are a fun person and that you're gonna have all the fun in the future. That's the five main reasons why you want to be picking the credit over the refund. If you have any doubts though, you can go ahead and click over here and watch a video on why picking the credit is the wrong idea and the refund is the best choice. With all that being said, thank you for watching and see you guys